What's going on, guys? Dr. Brute7 signing in back with another tutorial video. So I'm going to show you guys how to activate cheats on your games through the Edison Homebrew app. So if you want to know how to install the app, I've already shown on my tutorial where I have installed the Tesla overlay. Go into that video and check it out. I've already timestamped that part. It's a very short process. All you have to do is just copy and paste two files. That's it. And jump back right into this part of the tutorial. Now, keeping into account that you have already installed the Homebrew app, plug in your SD card or do what I am doing, FTPD. I have shown the tutorial how to install it. It's going to save you the hassle of plugging in your SD card by shutting down your Switch. You're never going to have to do that. There you go. I am connected to my Nintendo Switch. Go into the link in the description and then download this rare file, Switch Cheats Updater. Extract the contents, go into that folder. You're going to see only the .nro file. Just dismiss this one. I'm going to get into that later. It's a very important bit of information. Copy the .nro file and go into your Switch folder, paste it. Okay, time for the most important part of the tutorial. This system setting is an .ini file that can be found in the Atmosphere folder and by accessing the config_template subfolder. So this is where you're going to get the systemsettings.ini file. The purpose of me mentioning this is because it might ruin your gameplay experience. So every time you're going to update your Atmosphere custom firmware, it's going to by default activate all the cheats for your installed games. In order to prevent that from happening, locate this ini file, copy and paste it somewhere on your PC, open it through the Notepad or WordPad app, look for this command line. I'm going to zoom it for you guys. DMNT cheats enabled by default. So this is going to get resetted every time you're going to update your Atmosphere to a latest version. Locate this command line, delete this one, and instead of one, just type in zero. That's all you have to do. Save the file, copy that, go into the config templates, paste it. So it's going to ask you to replace, just go ahead and say yes to all, and that's it. So this is a very important step to keep in mind. This will save you from ruining the gameplay experience. So everything here has been done. I'm going to show you guys how to apply the cheats on our Nintendo Switch. Access your Homebrew app screen and then look for the Cheats Updater app. Here you're going to get two options. So here you're going to just go ahead and press A to download and update the cheat files. It's going to only install and apply the cheats for those games installed on your console. Now after the installation has been completed, press plus to quit and just go back to the menu. Here I'm going to just show you guys how to apply the cheats for one game. Just activate the Tesla overlay menu and select Edison and go to cheats, and here you're going to get all the cheats that can be found for this specific game. I'm just going to apply one cheat here, and yeah, I just increase the speed of the game. Link is going to go all berserk. This is how you apply the cheats. In order to deactivate the cheats, just go to Edison menu and deactivate the cheat from here. You're going to have to close the game and run it again in order for it to go back to normal. There you go. Now Link is all back to his former self, to his normal self. That is it. This is how you activate cheats through the Edison Homebrew app. If you have found this tutorial useful, please make sure to drop in a like and subscribe. That's gonna mean a lot to me. For now, Dr. Brute7 signing off. Peace.